Exporting inspection documents from SOLIDWORKS Inspection add-in is straightforward. We'll take you through the different export options and how we can modify Excel report templates to your own company standards. We're going to start with an existing ballooned drawing with an already created bill of characteristics. From inspection, there are multiple ways of exporting. The simplest exports are of the actual balloon drawing in themselves. This can either be done as a PDF or as an e-drawings file. Both will only export the balloon drawing. This won't include any information about the bill of characteristics. Typically, this is done in parallel with an Excel report. We'll start by exporting our drawing as an e-drawings file. E-drawings is a free CAD viewer for SOLIDWORKS native files that will allow anyone with the software to view the balloon drawing on their machine. I'm going to save just sheet one. This will open up e-drawings automatically and show us our balloon drawing. Once exported, if we notice any inaccuracies in the drawing, we can use e-drawings markups to help emphasize what's wrong. In this case, let's just take an example of the hole is the wrong size. So we can write a note next to that dimension, hole incorrect size. This can then be saved as a markup file, and this can then be emailed back to the engineering team. Usually this is a good workflow because e-drawing markup files typically are much smaller than e-drawings file, so they're much easier to email back and forth between teams, which makes it easier to communicate. To insert the markup back into our SOLIDWORKS file, we just simply copy it from our email, insert it in, and you can see that's brought our note through into our SOLIDWORKS drawing. Another inspection export option is export to SOLIDWORKS inspection project. We use this option if we want to take our add-in project into the standalone. This will include the balloon drawing as well as the bill of characteristics. From there, we can use the CMM functionality to import CMM results directly into our inspection file. We can then use these with our already existing bill of characteristics. Typically, once a drawing is exported, the bill of characteristics is also exported alongside it. In our example, we're going to use the export to Excel function. We're going to use one of the default templates, which is PPAP dimensional test results. And this is then going to export it to an Excel format. It should automatically load up. And you can see, once exported, we can see a list of our characteristics on the left. If these measurements pass, we'll end up with a visual pass or fail in those right-hand columns. So if we take characteristic number 4, which should be 50 millimeters, and we start adding in some measured values, so let's just go and just do 50s, you can see that that has actually gone in and passed our inspection test. If these were incorrect, you can see that it remains red and it hasn't passed. This is a great visual indicator to use to check if our characteristics are passing or failing at a quick glance. These templates are also very easy to modify. For example, if we want to add our logo and an extra column to the template we just used, we can use our template editor. This will open up our Excel report, and you should feel right at home as it's the same Excel user interface, but you've also got an extra dialog box. This is used for inserting the inspection characteristics. In our example, we're going to insert our logo for our company. The nice thing here is we can use the normal Excel tools. This one is just a JPEG. Just quickly resize that into the corner. We can also add in extra columns for different inspection characteristics. At the minute, it's quite a simple table. What I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a new column in between specification and test dated. And this column here is going to be for the method of inspection. So what we're going to do, using our inspection dialog, this is technically classed as a characteristic token, and you can see that there are loads in here by default. I want the inspection method. That then adds in that attributes. This is now finished and ready to be saved. We'll re-export using that new template, and we should now have our logo and a new column. With the inspection tools, it's easy to send accurate information quickly and communicate between teams with all the data needed for your inspection workflow.